What's going on, guys? Brandon here. We have your May 2019 Livingston County Real Estate Market Update. Let's jump right into this thing. So I always preface every single video with a couple things. We have 3 years of data there. That way you can see the pattern. If I showed you 1 year of data, would not make any sense. So 3 years of data, trend is your friend, as they say in the investing world. So that way you can see the patterns, you can see what's going on and where things are progressing. And then we have the month previous because all the data is there now, finally, and we can get that to you hot off the press. So let's jump right into this. Days on market, 46 days on market 2 years ago, 35 last year, and then 47 this year, so it bumped up again. Sometimes there's anomalies in the data, so we're gonna see if we can find any, but again, jumped up a little bit. It was a really steep seller's market last year. The numbers in general are kind of showing us that same thing though. Sometimes these numbers get a little bit skewed because there's not tons and tons of properties in Livingston County compared to say in Oakland or Wayne. So the data can get a little bit more skewed because of that. The sample sizes aren't as big. So active homes in the market, 734 2 years ago, 668 last year, and 767 this year. This is a 1 day snapshot. So the trend is more important than the actual number. So it is trending up that there are more homes on the market right now, because that's a 1 day snapshot. When the data was taken, there was that number of homes on the market that second. MOI is months of inventory. So at the rate that homes are selling, how long would it take to sell every last home without any new ones coming on the market? So two across the board, two, two, two. And I always tell everyone this to give the frame of reference. 1 to 3 months is a seller's market, meaning sellers get great prices. There's not a lot of homes in the market. 4 to 6 months is a balanced market. Everyone's winning. 7 months plus is a buyer's market, meaning there's a ton of inventory. Supply is very high. Demand is lower, so buyers are really making out. New homes in the market. So this is the number of new homes in the market that came out that month. So this is a better number if you're looking at the entire month. 588 2 years ago, 544 last year, and then 579 this past May. So again, a little bit of uptick, pretty steady actually the last 3 years in May. So kind of interesting, but again, another little uptick. So we'll see how these numbers play out in the months preceding this. Price per square foot, 135 2 years ago, 150 last year, and then 154 this past May. If you took the square footage of your home and multiplied it by this number, you would get the approximate value of your home. Now, this is countywide, so you're taking everything into consideration. So it's a rule of thumb. You know, if you actually want the price of your home, you have to have someone on our team, you know, a professional or an appraiser come and look at your home and give you an analysis and report on your home, because this just gives you a rule of thumb, a general idea of what's going on. Number of sold properties. So this is really our buyer statistic. How many closings were there in that month in that county? 340 2 years ago, 305 last year, and then back up a bit to 2017 levels to 337. So again, a good little uptick. Fortunately, last year was insane. So fortunately, we're back up a little bit. And hopefully that's climbing a little more and be a little bit more balanced to the market. That way, you know, when there's more balance, that means transactions are happening easier. Because even, you know, when sellers love high prices, but that means it prices a lot of people out of this market, so they can't buy. So, you know, it does have diminishing returns, obviously. So anyway, guys, that's your Livingston County market update for May 2019. I appreciate you guys more than anything. If you're listening on the podcast, go to @LegacyGroupMI on Facebook or YouTube. If you guys are in there, put your questions, comments, concerns in the comments there. That way everyone can benefit from the discourse there. Appreciate your time and energy. It's the most important thing we have. And we look forward to seeing you guys on the next one.